All I can say is that the fake news just doesn't get it, do they?
You know, they told us he was a monster. He was the most American president, truly into this country, President Trump. I tell people still, you want to see one of the greatest speeches ever, go 2 years ago yesterday, July 4th, his speech at Mount Rushmore will go down as one of the greatest speeches ever, so pro-American at a time when people are not into America that much. And that's kind of what you want from a leader. And July 4th wasn't just a big deal when he was running for re-election. 2019, there was an enormous turnout and celebration, and that is so appropriate for an American holiday, right? As for how things are now, people seem to be canceling July 4th, rolling it back. Joe Biden made an appearance on the balcony at the White House with his granddaughters, I guess. And then during the music portion, he had a little bit of trouble.
Thanks.
God bless America.
Okay, and
God bless America. Thank you.
And God protect our troops. Thank you.
Needed a little help there. We've seen it before. It happens. That was a subdued celebration. I noticed celebrations across America didn't seem to be all that. And now big-time celebrities are weighing in with open hostility towards our country. This is Jessica Chastain. She is usually a, well, pretty good actress. Happy Independence Day from me and my reproductive rights. Yeah, two middle fingers. Madonna put out this atrocious video. This is what it's like for if you're a woman living in America, yeah, getting arrested by the secret police. Kim Kardashian, who's been Trump-friendly at times, retweeted, 4th of July has been canceled due to a shortage of independence. Sincerely, women. This erosion of pride in America has been happening for a long time. I actually blame more than anybody Barack Obama. He was so not into America. And we had the warning signs all along. Remember his minister, this guy, Reverend Wright?
And then wants us to sing God Bless America? No, no, no. Not God Bless America. God damn America.
Yeah, right. A person who was friends with him became president of the United States. I do think that explains a lot of what we're going through right now. You heard about that horrible mass shooting in Highland Park. Here are the initial moments. All right, you hear the shots, people running away. It's terrible. Six people killed, dozens injured. There is a suspect in custody. Let's take a look at him. His name is Robert Cremo. And, yeah, he'll be 22 in September. And quite frankly to me, I've seen this type before. He looks a little Antifa-ish, doesn't he? All right, law enforcement, they're trying to do their best, I assume. Are they explaining away things? You know, he was caught wearing women's clothing. Here's how the police put it.
During the attack, Cremo was dressed in woman's clothing, and investigators do believe he did this to conceal his facial tattoos and his identity and help him during the escape with the other people who were fleeing the chaos.
Or maybe, like leftists all over the place, he liked wearing women's clothes even though he's a he. By the way, he identifies, at least in some social media postings, as a liberal. All right, I am a liberal. Now, is this, look, he's crazy if he did this, all right? This is a horribly deranged person, but I do notice they're not talking about motivations here. They do, however, whenever it seems that the shooter might at some point voted for a Republican, right?
We have this toxic stew of this growing right-wing ideology, easy access to guns, and our permissive internet culture that sort of rewards sharing some of this violent ideas.
This type of rhetoric doesn't just exist in the dark corners of the internet anymore. Over the last few years, these ideas have been mainstreamed by conservative television personalities and Republican politicians.
You see, they don't say, oh, he's a deranged nut job and who knows what set him off. No, they blame us. They blame us. Now, I'm not going to blame the left for what this guy, what motivated him. But I could. I could make that case. I'm not going to, because I'm going to say he was mostly deranged. Now, nobody in the media is talking about his motivations. Here is what they talk about instead.
There doesn't seem to be a place or an event where this can't happen.
Today, I'm just horribly, horribly, horribly sad. This is so unacceptable that an 18-year-old can have access.
It's about access to firearms. You can't have a mass shooting without a gun, and it's that access which is kind of the final piece of that pathway.
Access to weapons, high-capacity magazines, weapons that are made for war, that's the other part of this that we can do something about.
All right, not a word about the suspect. I mean, what websites was he looking at? Did he like this TV show or that TV show? They're very selective when they do that. I have a few hunches about this guy and a few things that we know, we saw. Anyway, hey, not too far from that horrible scene. It was horror all weekend long in Chicago. Take a look. Last time I saw something like this was in Baghdad, Iraq, all right? 2 years of saying the cops are racist, the society is systemically racist. This is what you get. In addition to crime, lots of it. New York City this weekend, 21 people shot. Back to Chicago, and this may have been just in a day and a half, 71 people shot in Chicago. Take a look at this. Philadelphia, two police officers shot. Now, fortunately, they're going to live. Funny that the Democrat mayor there, though, doesn't really want to be bothered. He's so over the job of being mayor.
Everything we have in the city over the last 7 years, I worry about. I don't enjoy 4th of July. I don't enjoy the Democratic National Convention. I don't enjoy the NFL draft. I'm waiting for something bad to happen all the time. So I'll be happy when I'm not here, when I'm not mayor, and I can enjoy some stuff.
You're looking forward to not being mayor?
Yeah, as a matter of fact.
Mayor Jim Kenney of Philadelphia, you might as well resign. Look at those cops behind him. Grim, focused, professional. And that clown of a mayor. So many political people are like that guy. Oh, this is much harder than I thought it was. Let me out. Let me out. Being mayor is a big deal. Hey, you want to talk about leadership? Rudy Giuliani. Gosh. Turned this city around in so many ways. And on September 11th, 2001. By the way, he's getting a heart procedure this week. He's going to be fine, going to have a stent put in. They are very good at doing that, but we obviously want him to pull through. And I know he will, and I predict he's going to get the Medal of Freedom someday.